Have you ever got so frustrated that you just give up on what you were doing and decided to send your Arduinos and motor shields to someone else to check out to see if they're working correctly? Well, that's what happened to me. Somebody sent me two motor shields and two Arduino Unos. Hi, I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. For years, I kept my model railroad equipment in storage. In fact, up until about 2012, that's where it stayed. Since then, I've been working hard trying to learn everything I could about model railroading. And then I started Tom's Trains and Things, this channel right here. And I'm sharing that experience with you in every video that I do. I had a viewer send me a bunch of emails. We were going back and forth for a while on his issues with the Arduino Uno and the Arduino motor shield. And he said he think he fried it. So eventually he said, well, let me send them to you so you could check them out. I got them in the mail today, and we're going to see if these things work. I'm doing a test on some components that a viewer sent me. He sent me two Arduino Unos and two motor shields. Here's one. I have the one hooked up below on one of my Arduino Unos. Here it is right here. That's my Uno on there. I just wanted to make sure that everything worked on there. I tested my Uno first with my motor shield. Everything tested out good. I put one of his motor shields on there, and the motor shield works. This one motor shield works. I tested it before. Let's see, short horn. And headlight. Well, let me back it up a little bit. Okay, put them back and forward so you can see the headlight. So, see the headlight comes on. Okay, so we know that half of this works, that the main track works on there. And let's bring up this right here. I'm going to put it on sound levels. I'm going to bring this sound level down real low and put this on the other track. Okay, now I'm going to write changes on sheet. Okay, first of all, we're going to look at the sheet for CVs. Okay, it's going to be that one there, 131, 35. I already edited it at one time. So we're going to go, I'm going to move it up all the way up here. Write changes on sheet. So it wrote changes on sheet. We'll come over to here. And you can see it's now at 235. So you can see that it programs. Now, what I did before was I read everything on there. So let's go and read full sheet. And you could see on the bottom of it where it scrolled down through there, and it's on OK already. So it read every CV on there. I can't snap my fingers, but just like that. But that's the first motor shield. Now let me check the second motor shield. Let me disconnect everything. I'm going to close out everything on the computer, close out JMRI. You see that I have my Arduino on COM 5. So what I'm going to do, and you can see that it, as soon as I pull the plug on it, it removes it. So I'm going to do it on, I'm going to plug in his Arduinos. I have it plugged in. You can see nothing happened there. This is the one, see, all four lights are lit. And I have it connected, but you didn't hear anything. Nothing came up on the device manager. And here's his other one. Now, that's what you should see but I don't have anything up on the device manager. Let me pull that one back up. That's close enough, but you can see this here, and there is nothing over there on the device manager. Now here's mine, and you can see it shows up on COM ports, Arduino COM port 5, so there we go on that one. Let me change everything onto his other motor shield to see if that works, and we'll take a look at that. I have everything transferred over to the new motor shield. Let me bring it over here. Okay, here's my Uno. Put this on there. There's his two bad Unos. We'll put that up there. There's the good motor shield that we tested already. So we're going to go plug in the Uno first. Okay, we hear it. And I'm using a wall ward on here. Right here. Plug that in. Put that right there. And put this into view. And we'll turn the power on to this. So I got power on now. Okay, but that one is not working. Okay, so you got one good one right here, one bad one right here. Okay, that motor shield doesn't work, and two of the Arduino Unos right there that are not working. But I plugged both of those in. One of them I have all four lights lit, and the other one I have two lights lit, the on light and the L light. And it's not supposed to have four lights on, and when I do it, it doesn't show up on the device manager. There's the device manager right there, and as you can see, I have Arduino Uno COM 5 on there, so nothing's showing up on it. Hit to reset. Nothing going on there, so we got one good motor shield out of the bunch, and I'll have to mark this one and send it back to you to let you know this is the good one right here. Going on the Arduino forum and other forums was no help in trying to find out what those lights on meant. On the Arduino, you normally have the on light on. See, this is the on light, and this is the one that's attached to pin 13. Now, with the DCC++ sketch on there, this is on. But you could see when I plug it in, it'll flash a little bit. Okay. The two other lights on there that were on the one, okay, these two center lights here are the transmit and receive lights, and they should only come on whenever you're uploading a sketch or you have other communications with, say, your serial monitor. But trying to look up what all four lights on meant at one time, it was no help. I Googled it and went on to different forums looking for it and really couldn't find a specific answer on it. And for this also, I really couldn't find a good answer for it other than if the sketch says that, you know, the pin 13 is high, it's going to light up on that sketch. Well, this is going out to Andy. I'm not quite sure what you did with your motor shields because you sent me two videos, and after the first video, the motor shield was working and you were having issues with connecting it to JMRI. And I walked you through of the steps that you should be taking to get it connected to JMRI. And the next thing I know, you sent me an email. You said, I think I burned out the motor shield. So I have no idea what you did to it. You didn't tell me that part. Then you sent me another video saying the same thing. You showed me that it was your new one was hooked up to JMRI, and
You had that part, but it wouldn't recognize your locomotive. So I put you through the steps of that. The next thing I know, you say, I burned up this one. So what you did between what I told you what to do and what you actually did are probably two different things. And I'm not quite sure what you did. Maybe you put too much voltage on it or what. I don't know. But I want to give you a few examples here of something. I was using a wall wart to power right here. Okay. Now, normally you'd do 12, 15 volts, maybe 18 volts for the Arduino motor shield. I think it's been tested that it'll take up to 18 volts on there. In fact, when I do mine around 16 volts. Sometimes I push it to 18 volts when I check it out. But, okay, I'm going to show you what I found on here. Now, my wall wart is rated at 12 volts DC, 1.5 amps. And as you can see right here, I'm getting almost 15 and a quarter, a little bit over 15 and a quarter volts out of it. So whatever your rating is on your wall wart, double check it. Now, this is an older style wall wart. I picked this up for $0.50, 12 volt, 1.5 amp, and it's a heavy one. It's got the coils in there. So what I would suggest is, if you're going to use something, get the electronic ones that are lightweight. This is your USB that takes 5 volts. On this barrel connector here, that is 7 to 12 volts. You can't put more than 12 volts on this. Even if you have a power supply that says 12 volts, you need to check it with the meter first before you put it on here to make sure you're not applying more than 12 volts. Up here on these connectors right here, you can put a higher voltage. But when you put that higher voltage in there, you need to cut this trace over here to make sure that that voltage up here doesn't go back down into the Arduino to burn it up. And I think that's what may have happened, because you said you cut this, and first time you said you cut the trace and you got a beep. Well, if you get a beep, you didn't cut the trace. It didn't get cut all the way through. And if you tried it out with that higher voltage, you probably did burn it out doing that, but you didn't tell me that. But anyway, right here, you finally did cut the pin going to there. That's another thing that you can do. Now, on both of these, the motor shields, the pins are cut. Now, I could see burning up the Uno by applying too much voltage to it, but I can't see burning up the motor shield. Now, one motor shield was good and one motor shield is not. And as you can see on this motor shield here, on these two Tinkerkit pins, the 4-pin Tinkerkit, I marked it with a magic marker to identify that this is the motor shield that works. You had this programmed correctly. All the lights were on that you showed me, but you were having issues trying to get it to work on JMRI. And that's where your problem was with JMRI, not with this. But whatever you did to these, you burned them up. And I have no idea what you did to them. Now, this goes out to all the modelers out there if you're going to be doing anything in the electronics projects. In a previous video, I showed you a regulated power supply that you could use, and you could even use it with your transformer. You could just hook up the, because there's no, it doesn't take 110. It takes anywhere from, I think this one was from 5 volts all the way up to 48 volts. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that. But this is a regulated power supply. When I showed it to you before, I didn't have the box for it. It was just this display and the board. But anyway, get you something like this if you're going to do anything in electronics. And I'll show you. Because even if you have this hooked up to a transformer, an old transformer, that is not a regulated power supply. That's just a power supply. The voltage can drop anywhere. But on this one here, we'll turn this on, and you can see I got this set for 5 volts. It's putting out 4.99 volts on there. So This is something that you might want to get. I got this at Banggood, and it's not cheap, but it will save your components from getting burned out because you know exactly what you're putting on those components. And you can see I was putting 22.1 volts into it, and I was getting 4.99 volts out. But this is also a good thing to have to test. Now, these aren't cheap. They're about 60 bucks, but they'll save you money in the long run because you will not be burning out components like this. Now, this right here, these are the original Arduino Uno and Arduino motor shields. And so there's about 45, 50 bucks right here. You have to make sure that the voltage that you're putting into it, into your components, is what is specified for those components. And if you don't know, try to look up and find the spec sheet on those components. Make sure you don't cross wires. Make sure you don't play around putting wires in where you're not supposed to be putting wires. And if you're re-experimenting with things, make sure that you disconnect it from the power if you're separating it and putting it back together. Make sure the power is off when you do things like that. If you don't want to spend the money on something like this for your projects, you could always get a buck converter. Now, I got a package of five of these for about $6 on Amazon. And basically all it does is takes the voltage and drops it down to a regulated voltage. This right here, you know, probably $1, $1.50. I think this is rated at 3 amps. This one right here is good if you're going to be doing a lot of projects and you want to do some testing on it. This one here, or this one right here. This is Provono, and this is about 60 bucks. If you're going to be doing anything, make sure you have the right voltage on there, and whenever you're switching things around, do not do it while the power is on. Disconnect the power and then move your jumpers around, disconnect your Arduino from your motor shield, all with power off, so you can make sure that you're not going to burn anything out. Andy, I don't know what you did with these. I have no idea because you're not telling me what you did in between the instructions that I gave you and when you came back with the following email saying that I think I burned these out. Your problem was with JMRI, configuring your JMRI, not with these. These were good, but whatever you did with them, I don't know. You burn them out somehow. You're not telling me how you did it. But that's all we have on that right now. I'm going to have to send these things back to him. Andy, I'm sorry I didn't have any better news, but at least you have one component that is still good. So, until the next time, we'll see you.